But I did want an opportunity to put on record my grave reservations in relation to the manner in which this government is handling what they themselves describe as a monumental change in the delivery of an important utility to our citizens. And I have to say, we were criticised after 14 years in government, as certain previous ministers being arrogant and being out of touch. But my God of Almighty, the arrogance and the manner in which this government is out of touch with what the people are thinking is beyond belief. To listen to Minister Kelly this morning on Morning Ireland talk about how most of these changes were going to come about regardless of the protest, that he himself didn't believe in some of the proposals that were put to the people or put to this Oireachtas before any protests. Do people, or does this government take the people of Ireland to be fools? Be under low illusions. The only reason there was monumental U-turns and changes is because the people of Ireland spoke, and they spoke in considerable numbers. And it wasn't the normal doom and gloom merchants. It wasn't the normal people that would be out protesting regardless of what banner was being lifted in the air. This was, for the main part, ordinary, decent, hard-working people who have come to say we have had enough and we can take no more. And when you were looking at doing the U-turns and changing the tact in which you were progressing, you should have done it, and you should have done it right. And what you should have done was should have abolished Irish Water, a conception of Fine Gael supported by Labour, a conception which an over-bloated quango, which was bonus-driven, and which it was this government and the members of this government and the backbenchers that willingly supported and voted for it. And isn't it amazing then when you listen to ministers saying they always felt that there needed to be change? We didn't hear a peep from government ministers, from junior ministers, or from government backbenchers. And certainly I didn't see in my constituency any of my constituency colleagues standing in solidarity with the people of Mullingar or the people of Athlone. And when I submitted parliamentary questions prior to these protests, it came back about the PPS number. Minister Kelly himself said it was a necessity. Only 5 weeks ago, in a reply to a parliamentary question, it was a necessity. Where is that necessity now? And the worst about this, the worst about the changes, and I welcome the fact that people are going to be paying less, because people cannot pay any more. They're put to the pin of the collar. And it's ordinary, decent, hard-working people who are paying high mortgages, who are paying high childcare, another issue that this government has ignored for 3.5 years. But what have they done? They've brought about a system that's totally inequitable and unfair. And can I ask the three government members that are in the House now, do they think it's fair? Do they think it's fair that someone like Mr. Tierney, the CEO of Irish Water, earning €200,000 per annum after getting a big handshake from his previous employment, do they think it's fair that he pays the exact same as someone on a non-contributory old age pension of €220 a week? Where's the fairness? Where's the equity there? It's not there. And where's the Labour Party, a party that always has espoused that they were going to be here to fight for fairness and equity? There's no fairness, there's no equity in this. And most of all, when we talk about global warming, when we talk about water being a scarce resource, there's no incentive there for people to conserve water. The whole beauty and the whole concept and the whole reason and rationale for bringing in meters was to ensure that there was conservation of water.
Thank you, Dibs.
People will not conserve water going forward. And that is a big, big mistake. What we have now is a brainchild of this government that we're going to spend and have spent 180 million on the creation of Irish Water, 500 million on the installation of meters, countless other millions. And what are we going to get in return? Less than 100 million a year. Abolish Irish Water, suspend the introduction of charges, fix the leaks, make sure that everybody has proper, safe drinking water going into their taps, and then come back in a number of years and re-examine what we do going forward.